Alright, so here's part two of my video from the other day. I went up fries, got the extra parts I needed. So what you're looking at right now is the resistor I had to get. As you can see, 10 watts, 1.5 ohms. So I just soldered that in between one of the 5 volt red wires and the black, one of the more black ground. And that puts a little bit of a load on the 5 volt circuit to help steady things out and bring up the voltage to a nice steady level for everything else. And then the other thing I did, so it's got this power switch built in down here, but I also had some leftover wires, right? So the gray wire there is five power good. So once it received a signal that the other circuits were up to their full voltage, that would signal the motherboard that everything was ready to work. So, or actually I guess it would be a signal from the motherboard that everything was ready to work. So what I did is took that one, which will also be, I believe, a 5 volt line, and I soldered it to an LED, right? So we got the gray one to the positive side, black one to the negative side. I just got a little LED from Fry's again. You know, everything's at Fry's. And it came with a little cup. So I popped it in through the hole. And what's cool about that is there's, you can see a little delay when you turn it on as it runs its little check and makes sure that the voltages that are coming out are actually good. So that's about it, really. That's the little fan header, goes to the fan on the cap. And those are the differences of what happened from the last video to this one. So, you can watch it happen here. Flip it on, and you'll see like a half second delay between flipping it on and when that power light comes on. Tell me everything's good. I was hoping it would be a lot brighter. First time I ever did anything with LED, so I was just going to leave it inside the case here somewhere and have it be backlit through the mesh, but turned out not be so bright, so I just stuck it through the hole there. But there's our fan working, and that should be enough cooling, I think, to cool this down. This sucker does get kind of hot. Just burned my finger a little bit touching it, but anyway, and I still got to make up some labels. But so I took my test leads into the ground, 12 volt and 5 volt. Now this multimeter I have is kind of crappy, but alright, so it's reading 12.5 on the 12 volt line. I know this meter is not exact. I've used it before and compared to other people's multimeters, and it was a little bit off, but it's very old as well. So 12 volt line, and put it on the 5 volt line. So it reads just over 5 volts. So this will work out. I did got some batteries for a labeler, and I can just put a 5 volt 12 and a GND there. It look pretty professional. So it's worked out pretty well. I'm very happy with it, and like total cost involved was, like I said last time, under 20 bucks. I got this 5 volt green LED built-in resistor at Fry's. This was like 99 cents. I even bought the other resistors if I needed them. These were like another 99 cents, so big deal, you know. And then that's the resistor I had to buy last time. They came 2 in a pack. I think it was $1.50. This is super cheap. The only other thing you might need to buy if you don't have it, of course, is a soldering gun, some solder. I had some heat shrink left over from another project, so this was total involved, like 20 bucks. So pretty happy with it. Alright, and here's the final product. All put back together. Fans on and blowing. Got out the label maker. Looks pretty good. Works just fine. So that's what I did. Worked for me. Depending on your power supply, you may have a couple other wires that you might need to research, but from what I've seen online and on other YouTube videos, this is pretty standard for the current ATX specs. So that's how you can take a cheap power supply from an old computer and make a good 12-volt power supply for your RC chargers. All right, thanks for watching.